you are most welcome to the language class. Today we will do chapter 12, that is modals, will, may and must. Here a dialogue is given. Ayush, Rashi, two characters are there. Ayush, Rashi, look at this notice in the newspaper. The electricity supply will be discontinued from 4 to 5 p.m. Some high voltage service lines will be repaired during that time. We are sorry for the trouble you may face during that hour. That means this is a notice given in the newspaper by the electricity board or office. So it is written that the electricity supply will be disconnected. That means in the morning we are reading the news that at 4 to 5 p.m. it will be disconnected. And some high voltage service lines will be repaired. Okay, we must miss the inauguration of the World Cup. So now, Ayush is telling that they will not be able to see the World Cup. Okay, World Cup inauguration, that means the first starting day. Rashi, we must plan something. That means we have to make a fixed plan. Must is used for fixed plan. Shall we go to Uncle Suresh's place? They may have electricity at that time. Ayush, good idea. We will do that. We must. So Ayush is telling, yes, we can do that. We will do that, and we must means the fixed, that yes, we will do that in the fixed. So look at the uses of will and will not. Sometimes we use the shortened form of forms such as apostrophe double L or for will and owned for will not. This is a good book on using the computer. This is a good book on using the computer. So this is a suggestion. We will read it together. So this is also a suggestion that this is a good book and we will read. I won't go into that cave. That means negative. Okay, it is telling about the future. We will read together. This is future, telling about the future, but positive. And I won't go into the cave, that is negative. I will help you with your homework if you want. So it is telling that it is also a suggestion. It is also a suggestion. It's very hot, so I will take a taxi. So it's very hot and I will take a taxi. This is also a type of suggestion. Number D. It is an instant decision. It is an instant decision. I will call you tomorrow. A promise. I will call you tomorrow. This is a promise. Since there is no electricity, the water supply won't be working either. It is a prediction that if there will be no electricity, so the water supply will be disconnected. Okay. So number A and B is for the future action, but number A is for positive and number B is for negative. Number C is a suggestion, or it is a suggesting something. Number C is suggesting. Number D, it's very hot. That is an instant decision. And number E is a promise. And number F is a prediction. Now, we will now look at the uses of would and would not or wouldn't. The short form of would not is wouldn't. Would you pass the bread, please? This is a request. So to do a request, we can use would. Would you mind if I use your computer? This is an permission. For asking permission also, we are using would. I would like tea. Talking about what one prefers. I would like tea. That means he is preferring. He likes a thing. Okay.
Now, would tomorrow be all right for the meeting, making arrangement? So, this one is, we can use would for making arrangements. Or inviting also. Would you like to take a boat ride with us? That means they are inviting. So, for inviting, we can use would. I wouldn't be at school that day. Talking about a future action. It is talking about a future action. Use the correct modal to complete sentences. Use short form where necessary. We dash do something new today. We will do something new today. One of you dash start a story. One of you will start a story. Each student would take turns to add a sentence. We will complete the story that way. And rest two you will do, okay, in the book only. Next, we will now learn to use the may and might. The dry weather might start a forest fire. It is a small possibility. She may not be home. This is also a possibility. May I use your pen seeking permission? Yes, you may, giving permission. So, we can use may for possibility, seeking permission and giving permission. And might only for small possibility. Okay, next. Look at some uses and functions of must. And this one you will do, okay. This one, let's practice. There are dark clouds in the sky. It is possibility, so we have to do. It may rain soon. And for like this, we will do. Next, Sakshi is taller than Arun. Tenzin is taller than Sakshi. Tenzin must be taller than Arun. So, Sakshi is taller than Arun and Tenzin is taller than Sakshi. So, Tenzin must be the taller than Arun. Okay. To express a conclusion. We use must to express a conclusion. We must start early to reach the fort before noon. To express a necessity. To express a necessity, we use must. Doctor, you must not have spicy food. To give a strong order. So, to give a strong order, we use must. You must not open the gift till your birthday. To say what should and should not be done. Okay. What should be done and what not should not be done. State the functions of must not in the sentences below. You must clean up after you finish playing. To order. So you have to say how, in which cases we are using. The phone is ringing. It must be my father. So to express a conclusion. It is to express a conclusion. So like this we will do. And I will give the answers in the next class. Did you notice that the present tense forms of modals do not take s after he, she, it, dog, bird, car and all such singular forms? So, the modal verbs are not taking s with them when the subject is singular. Okay, it is, we are using as it is. That means he can, she can, they can, you can. We will not say he may or she cans. We will not add is with the modal verbs. Next, use the correct modals in the sentences below. And not where necessary. You dash never hurt animals. They feel pain just as we do. You must never hurt animals. They feel as
We too, just as we do. Next, you dash run fast without a good pair of shoes. You must not, because it is impossible. Correct modals. Oh, if we can use all the types of modals, that means will, may, and will, may, might, would, and must. Here. So number two is you may not run fast without a good pair of shoes. You dash buy a good pair. You must buy a good pair. Okay. So do this one. And this revision part you will read. This revision part you will read. Okay. So till the next class. Goodbye. Have a nice time. And practice and do the homework in the book only.